Well, now that she's done holding her breath, let's continue. Oh, no. I mean... we've just about reached our destination. You can see on the right we've reached something. But, let's burn another one just to make sure we don't have any more annoyances, shall we? I'm in the medicine tab, though. That's never gonna work. Ha 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 ha. Alright. There's this guy here, but you know what? We're gonna let him rock. Up there, though, there's a cave. My very best swimsuit. And my very best Pokemon. Now, she looks the same as everybody else, but we're not gonna tell her that. If she really likes her swimsuit, we're just gonna let that rock. I'm gonna try this, and if we die for it, so be it. Nope, we outsped. Oh. Following the latest trend. Not exactly. But I suppose you could say we're somewhat trendy. Who do I want leading this mess? Let's put Venusaur up front. So, we surf out here, we get to a dead end. Absol. Get him out of here. Well, you know what? I can't hate on you for the attitude. It was a good battle. Somebody put a notice underneath the sign for the old Seafoam Islands. The Cinnabar Gym has moved here. Leader Blaine. Yes. Give me that music again. Now, we can actually go through the Seafoam Islands proper, but to do that, we have to go the other direction. Here, we seem to have stumbled into the gym. It's a work in progress, apparently. Trainers. Rocks. Keep your cool and beat the trainers one by one, and you'll surely find the path. There's Blaine, by the way, in the middle, looking dapper. Never forget to do the laundry. Well, I mean, we have just the thing for Paris now, right? We'll always have Paris. It's early, but that makes us think that we're looking at bugger grass here for this gym. It's pure white in my head. Alright, now he moves out of the way. He pieces out. We're just gonna fight our way through.
A super nerd.
Combi. That's two bugs. bitterness leads to improvement tomorrow. Now, at some point, we gotta figure out which one of these guys is gonna let us in. I don't think it's this one. Perseverance is what motivates me. Also, I'm no longer worried about this gym because, bug. I'm gonna look to move Venusaur out of the first spot just to preserve a couple of those, sacred fires. For Blaine. You know, to remind him what he's supposed to be. Likewise, we'll probably just wait to use Typhlosion, although, he's got 18 flamethrowers. So he just moves in. Now you're like, but I need to get in there, and he doesn't care. This guy does not care. Man, Rhyperior's gonna mash here too. Should probably heal him up a little bit. Rayquaza's good. I mean, this is gonna be... I don't know if that's an easier type for our team. Especially coupled with the fact that bugs generally suck anyways. This, of course, is a departure from Blaine's usual stuff, where he likes to quiz people and you can avoid the fights by answering things correctly. I suppose we're supposed to assume that those all got destroyed, you know, when a mountain exploded and a volcano erupted, and somehow the topography of Cinnabar Island got higher when that happened, but that's neither here nor there. I'm not done! Oh, you are. You are, my friend. He also moves in. Now that leaves this dude over there, but before we do that, let's fight this guy. Because once we beat Blaine, there won't be a chance to fight him. Insert damn Daniel joke here. It's a Shedinja, but we have the answer. Of course, unless it has Wonder Guard, which I think some of these did. Wasn't that a thing at one point? I feel like that was actually an ability that we stumbled upon that was on the correct Pokemon. Anyways, it had 1 HP and it died. Never put us in the same category as scientists who help bad guys. Even if we had come at him from the other side, I think he would have just moved back into this square, so we would have had to go around. But now you'll notice this guy has a couple different spaces he can move into. You look easily defeated. Do I? I mean, you could have... Maybe the rocks are blocking your vision, but it seems like you could have peeped around the room and watched me murder everybody around here. Ah, old Shuckle. Does Shuckle have a weakness? I don't think so. Bug Rock is a weird typing. But, Bug neutralizes Rock's weaknesses except for Water. Water is, I think, the one weakness. Anyways. Obscene defenses, no attack stats, mediocre at best HP. So this is a concern until you see the damage, and then you go, oh. I think all that hail means is that we're definitely in 3-hit kill range. So we'll just stick it out. The thing about Rock Tomb is, yeah, it's lowering our speed, but its speed is also abysmal. I feel like its base stat in attack and special attack and speed are all 10. If not 10, then something like that. I think it could hit us with 6 Rock Tombs and our speed could drop all those stages and we'd still be faster by 2 or 3 times. Anyway, it's dead. I tried to rock a Shuckle for a while, and it just... I don't know. It didn't work. Hey, you! Yeah. That's gotta suck, Blaine. Take a look at this cave. I'm still the gym leader, which is good, because, I mean... what would happen otherwise? Found a hat. It's pretty cool. Doing a peace sign with a cool mustache. Walking cane, chrome dome so shiny it sparkled when it took the hat off. And he leads with a Caterpie. Man, the universe has not been kind to Blaine. Must be frustrating to have your gym get burned down after all that work. Go and rebuild it. But be stuck off in Seafoam Island where it's really difficult for people to get to you. In fact, we can only get to it from this side because of the earthquake slash volcano slash mega death that happened. Just remember, we tried to go south from Fuchsia and it didn't work. Heracross, I have just the answer. Now he's got this gym set up, it's sort of coming together. A bunch of scientists are either here to help out or get in the way, I don't know which. And he's got bug types, which are weak to the type he's supposed to have. I can't escape, but Heracross is dead because this is 4x damage. I mean, it doesn't really matter. Let's let Rhyperior try to fight this out. This might not work, but... it's only gonna take one attack. The spirit of this cave gym, and he went up to level 59, BTW. Horn Drill. Ah, critical hit. I was wondering, there's a chance that might have killed one rock anyways? I don't know. 4x damage is a real devastating thing. It's about the only reason Garchomp wasn't permanently in the Uber tier, because it has a 4x ice weakness. Otherwise, it's super good. Overheat. That's a slight drawback. We have to hold a rematch. You can't actually rematch the gym leaders in this game. It's a pain in the ass, but it's doable. Basically, you have to go around and collect all their phone numbers, and then either you can call them at a specific time, or they can call you. I don't remember which. But, there's like a window of, I don't know, 4 hours, one day of the week, where you can rematch them. Kind of frustrating coming on the heels of Platinum, which was probably my favorite in the series for post-game content. That one had a battle underground, a battle, the Chateau, I think, is a newer game, whatever it was called, where it was just like this kind of cool underground bar that you showed up at, and all the gym leaders would show up, and the Elite Four people occasionally showed up too, and a couple other notable people that you battled with at certain points showed up at. And you could just rematch them. You couldn't control who was there, but there was a selection of like 3 to 5 every day, I think, and they were all high level, good for leveling. Fun fights to begin with. And unfortunately, we haven't really seen anything like that since. Hell, in one of the recent games, I want to say X, you couldn't even rematch the Elite Four. That's a serious tradition. You beat them once, and then you become the champion. You go back later, and they're stronger. Not so much here. Anyways, it's important not to forget this step. The temptation is to be like, oh, cool, I got the 7th gym badge. I can go to Viridian, and hey, I'll battle Gary. No, he's still waiting here for you to come and check on him. Flash your badge, and he's like, okay, cool, bye. This is another spot where the pacing's weird, though. We've already come through Viridian. We can just fly to it and head straight to the gym. There's nothing stopping us. Oh, my rappel. Were you able to battle the leader? No, I haven't walked inside yet. You should know, I just turned the corner. Apparently we have no choice but to talk to him this time. Put away your Pokemon. No! He's no pushover. Yeah, I mean, he didn't just battle a champion. He was the champion, like he said. He was the champion for all of 2 seconds, but that's not the point. And apparently he's decided to adopt Giovanni's method here of floor tiles. So we can run around and touch stuff, and most of it's going to kick us back to here. This one's going to do the same thing. Just out of my own morbid curiosity, what happens... Oh, I see. These are probably like stop tiles. I thought they were holes in the floor. It's really hard to tell from this angle. Anyway, fight me and see. Arabella. Can't decide if that's a cool name or a terrible name. String shot. These are not tactics we're supposed to be seeing at this level. String shot's more of a level 3 thing than a level 53 thing. But, you know, everybody makes mistakes. We also can't definitively lock down what type this gym is yet. And in the original, while Giovanni was ground, he had trainers who had all sorts of stuff, so there's no real guarantees here. And again, seeing Hitmonchan second makes you think, well, that's probably got to be fighting then. What the hell is a Hitmonchan even doing with Weather Ball? That's apparently the best it's got, too. It went to it twice. No fighting move for stab, no nothing. No weather move. That's that guy's fourth line of dialogue, and I still have no idea what the hell he's talking about. Alright, so we have no choice but to head back to the start. As you can see, we're locked in here. We have to go into these arrows or down. So we gotta go past him. Alright, that was the easy one. Now let's take a look. I guess we can get over this way. Never seen such a wonderful gym. I mean, it's cool looking. I haven't really missed the floor tile puzzles, but fine. You of course know who's going to be doing a lot of work here. Typhlosion has some options. Works great against the Blaziken because it blocks the fire, but we have two better options. Specifically, Venusaur and Rayquaza. Venusaur takes 1/4 damage from fighting. Rayquaza's taken half and also has super effective moves to lash out with. Another fire attack, huh? Okay. Wondering if Aerial Ace was going to be enough. Now, with the defense up, I don't think so. And Infernapes are pretty fast, so I'm not shocked that it outsped us. It's kind of the rare breed among starters in that it has more defined stats than a well-rounded approach. Most starters are like Venusaur, where it's just a pretty even stat distribution, but there's a few exceptions. Super Fang, just there to annoy us. Thank you. whatever. Not really the attitude to have, sir. Not really the attitude to have. Let's see. We gotta get out of here somehow. Do we have any choice but to go back to the start now that we've done this? I don't think so. No. Alright, so. Here, and then there, and then that. But now look at all this ground we have to cover up. Gotta figure out somewhere to go. This is a place that's another stopping point. And then look around and we go there, and that should be another stopping point. Oh, no, I misread. It is another stopping point, though. And we can go here. Get to this. And then, God, how do we even get over there? What a mess. Any of those left arrows are death. That sends us all the way back to the start. We can do this. Look at this dumb path that goes up to Gary. I'm trying to see... I guess we have to get around. Oh, I see. There's more up here than before Gary. Okay. Yeah, we should be able to sneak around to get to that trainer that we just passed down below us. Actually, it's a pretty decent look for us, too. Wipe out the Breloom first, and then we'll see if a Petal Dance can kill Makuhita. It probably can, since it's not the evolved form. I used to think Makuhita looked like it had a trash bag on its head, and it didn't make much sense to me. And then we actually got a trash bag Pokemon, and I didn't care anymore. Looking at your opponent's strength is also very important. Oh, I messed up. Shouldn't have hit that. Well, that's going to get me to the fight I want anyways, I suppose. I suppose. Well, yeah, especially those longer stretches. We just keep spinning and spinning, and then there we are. Bonita! Oh, you're so pretty. I guess we should just use our last Luster Purge. We'll have Typhlosion take a bit of a backseat on the Gym Leader anyways, so that's okay. Let's take a chance here. It's going to be difficult for Rhyperior to find a favorable matchup here because fighting is effective against Rock, but we can fight back with our own super effective stuff, Water Spout. What an answer. This might kill. Water Spout does more damage the more HP you have, and Combusken's full, so that's like 150 base, I think, in that case. Yeah. Yeah, it's not great. And of course, we're four times weak to water with poor, poor Rhyperior. But you know what? That actually hasn't happened to him as much as I thought it would, especially with everything being randomized. So it's hard to complain.
Bonita. He's so pretty.
Oh, I shouldn't have touched that. I didn't think about the long-term consequences here. Alright, so all I have to do is get back to that, well, get back to that square. And then we want this arrow right here. That allows us to go up. So we'll leave off here tomorrow. We'll fight Gary, see what he's rocking. Does he have a balanced team? Does he have a team of one type? Who the hell knows? His gym badge symbol's up on the wall there. From there, we're actually not too far off from the end of this playthrough. Because then we just head straight back to the Elite Four. And then there's one other matter to take care of. And people who've played this game know what I'm talking about.